Of the 9 districts and 1 city in the Lango sub-region, Dokolo had remained the opposition Forum for Democratic Change stronghold, with the district predominantly being dominated by the party. But the cog is now beginning to turn in the opposite direction. From 2006, when Dokolo was carved from Lira, Cecilia Barbara Timogwal, UPC turned FDC was elected into parliament. Ogwal's political ambitions have seen overwhelming support for the party. Dokolo is currently under the stewardship of FDC James Otto Apili, the Dokolo District LC5 chairman. Similarly, the ruling NRM party had gained massive support, the district predominantly being dominated by the NRM supporters. The party has produced 2 legislators, with Felix Okot Ogong for Dokolo South and Moses Ogwal Goli for Dokolo North constituency. In the by-election conducted on March 21st, 2024, to replace the fallen Dokoloman Member of Parliament Cecilia Ogwal, the Uganda People's Congress Party, UPC, snatched the woman Member of Parliament seat for Dokolo. Sarah Aguti Nyankori garnered 23,044 votes against her closest rival, Janet Rose Adong Alau of NRM, who obtained 14,001 votes. FDC flag bearer Dr. Rosemary Aroch Ogwal got 8,168 votes. NUPS candidate Harriet Ageno garnered 727 votes. Esther Akulo, an independent candidate, got 790 votes, and her counterpart Rebecca Arao obtained 439 votes. A total of 47,169 votes were cast in the 173 polling stations in the 14 sub-counties in the district, according to the election results announced by the Dokolo returning officer. John Bosco Otoke, the NRM administrative secretary for Dokolo District, says NRM lost the Dokolo by-election because of unresolved bickering in the region.
It was moving in one accord. There were a lot of factions, and the worst one, which now hit us down, was the luring of an independent candidate at the last moment, when she was already nominated as a candidate, though leaning to NRM.
According to Otoke, the stepping down of Dr. Lalam a day to the by-election caused NRM a big loss.
I would believe if this candidate participated, she was going to scoop part of the votes, and then the protest votes which went to UPC wouldn't have gone there. That's my own analysis, and I have carefully looked at that.
However, Tony Obel Aguata, the Town Council LC3 chairperson, attributed the loss to the Much Love and Trust the People of Lango have to Jimmy James Michael Akena, the UPC party president and Obote's son.
To see election where Akena is involved in Lango, you just know straight away that it is for UPC. I can compare you with election that has happened in Apach, the one that has happened in Uyam, and lastly, the one that has just happened in Dokolo. UPC got victory through the loves that people have on Akena.
Patrick Oboy Amriat, the FDC party president, said FDC lost due to the propaganda the UPC leaders traded on his candidate.
They were unfair to us, you know, in portraying our candidate as foreign to Dokolo and somebody who does not deserve to be elected in Dokolo. And that really played into the minds of the population in Dokolo.
Fred Ebil, the UPC Secretary General of UPC, says UPC won the Dokolo by-election with a landslide because of the clear agenda.
Us as a party, we have an ideological school where we train our candidates what to say and where to say it. That is the difference between us and other parties.
In 2007, Yisa Otto Amiza, the UPC candidate, won Oyam South by-election to replace the fallen Dr. Yafes Akulo Epak. Otto defeated the independent candidate Nelson Adea, Ruth Atala Adupa, and NRM Ogwang Ada. In the midterm election of Epak municipality held in 2018, Patrick Ochan, a UPC candidate, garnered 6,597 votes, beating his closest rival, Jovino Akaki, the NRM candidate, who obtained 3,233 votes and others. Oyam North by-election to replace Kano Okelo Engola was won by Dr. Eunice Apio Otuko on UPC ticket, and the Dokolo by-election, where the UPC flag bearer Sarah Aguti Nyankori was declared winner. Report compiled by Solomon Okabo. for the news.